Okay, so good day to everyone, and let's discuss our subject for today about the climate change. So last meeting we discussed about the definition of climate change, wherein this is a global modification of the climate over a long period of time. So ibig sabihin class that when we see global, it is referring to the whole entire world, ano? So when we see world, we are referring to Earth, ano? Our planet Earth. So climate change is not only happening in our place, in our province, in the city, but also it happened to country or throughout the world. Yan. So this climate change is not only a change in 1 second or in one night only or in a day or in a year, but this has a phase, okay? Because this was taking place way back a million years or 1,000 years ago, no? So yung mga nararanasan natin ngayon na matinding init ng panahon, matinding taglamig naman kapag taglamig na panahon natin kasi wala naman tayong winter. Okay? So, yan yung mga instances na kung saan ay it affects o kaya ay nararamdaman natin yung pagbabago ng panahon. Sabi nga ng mga lola, lolo natin, hindi naman ganito eh, noon. Yun. No? Ngayong panahon na ito, tag-ulan sana eh. Okay, di ba? Kaya nga yung mga pananim ng ating mga magsasaka, eh dapat wala sanang madra-drought. Eh ang problema, merong natatamaan ng drought, rainy season supposedly sana ngayon. Okay? So, ano ba yung weather na sinasabi? Ano? When we see weather, yung pag TV patrol, ano? Yung pinapalabas ni Kuya Kim, sinasabi niya yung weather conditions, kaya nade-detect nila ano yung ano ba ang panahon kinabukasan, okay? And that is the state of the atmosphere, ano yung surroundings natin, describing for example the degree to which it is hot or cold, no? O kaya ay pwedeng uulan, o kaya ay maganda ang panahon, no? So, yan, ano yung concept ng weather natin. So, based sa weather, yan natin nakikita ano kung uulan ba o kaya ay mainit ang panahon. Pero yun nga ang problema natin because of the climate change. Hindi natin ma-predict no, ang weather condition natin kasi minsan na-experience natin na ang ganda ng araw, sikat ng araw. Pero mamaya, bigla-bigla na lang aambon. Di ba? Bigla-bigla na lang uulan. O kaya naman ay umuulan, pag gising natin, umuulan, umaambon, tapos mamaya-maya ang ganda ng sikat ng araw. Yan. So, bakit nagkakaganon? Because of climate change. Yan. That's why in here, ano, climate change, the average weather pattern in a place over several decades is called climate. Ayan, yung mga usual na nararanasan daw noong unang panahon, that is climate. That is different regions have different regional climate. Totoo yan. Ano? Global climate refers to the average of all regional climate. So, ibig sabihin kung ano yung nararanasan ng kabuuan, okay? Nararanasan din, nararanasan nating lahat. Okay, di ba? So, kagaya ng yung sabi dyan na iba-iba yung weather conditions depende sa lugar. That's true. Kagaya ng Baguio o kaya ay mountain area, ano? Sa Patag, no, kapag tag-araw talaga, mararanasan mo yung talagang mainit na panahon. Tag-araw din doon sa bundok, sa bulubunduking lugar, kaya nga lang hindi yung tag-araw na nararanasan natin dito sa lowland. Ayan. So, weather is affected by El Nino o kaya ay La Nina. Yan yung term na ginagamit natin kapag yan ay tag-araw at tag-ulan. Okay, kapag tag-araw, that is El Nino. Kapag tag-ulan naman, yan naman ay La Nina. No? So, climate events like this affect the weather in many areas of the world, causing extreme events like storm o kaya ay drought. Yan. So, ano nga ba ang climate system? When we say climate system, this is a highly complex system consisting of a 5 major component, no? So ano ba yung component na yan? Yan yung atmosphere, yan yung hydrosphere, yan yung cryosphere, lithosphere, and the biosphere. Yan. Pag sinabi nating cryosphere, okay, this includes snow, sea ice, lake and river ice, yung mga nag-a-ice sa mga malalamig na lugar, just like Antarctica. Pag sinabi naman nating lithosphere, class, ano, we are referring to the rocky outer part of the earth. It is made up of the brittle crust and the top part of the upper mantle of the earth, ano. So the lithosphere is the coolest and the most rigid part of the earth. Ayan, huwag niyong kalilimutan yan, ano? And pag sinabi nating biosphere, this is a made up of the part of the earth where life exists. Ayan, sa salitang bio, ano? May buhay, pag, di ba? In science, pag sinabi nating biology, study of living things, no? Pag sinabi naman nating biosphere, this extends from the deepest root systems of trees to the dark environment of ocean trenches, no, na may mga buhay. Ayan. Okay, so the climate system evolves in time under the influence of its own internal dynamics and because of the external forcing such as volcanic eruption. Yan pa yung isang component ano ng climate system natin. Maliban sa because of human intervention, meron din tayong tinatawag na natural intervention. And that is the external forcing, ano? Wherein nandiyan na yung volcanic eruption, okay? Solar variations, anthropogenic forcing such as changing composition of the atmosphere and the land use change, di ba? May mga natitibag, may mga nalalandslide, okay? So, that is also a component of climate system. The physical science assessment focuses on four topics. Yeah. So, dito tayo sa physical science of climate change. Yeah, no? So, in here, we have the four topics, ano, the drivers of climate change, changes observed in climate system, understanding cause and effect relationship, and projection of future changes. Yeah, so this was studied and evaluated in the IPCC assessment in 2001. So kapag sinabi nating IPCC, this refers to the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. So ibig sabihin, ito yung samahan ng iba't ibang bansa, no? Na kung saan nagtutulungan sila upang sa ganun ay ma-prevent, ano? Itong talagang nararamdaman nating climate change. Okay? So yan yung IPCC, ano? Don't forget the definition or meaning of the IPCC, which stands Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. Yan. Okay? So, let's proceed to the drivers of climate change. No? As stated therein, atmospheric concentration of many gases, primarily carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, and halocarbons, okay, have increased because of human activities. Okay, such gases traps thermal energy within the atmosphere by means of the well-known greenhouse effect. Kasi meron kasi tayong mga greenhouse gases. Ngayon, kapag itong mga greenhouse gases ay pinatamaan ng mga man-made na mga toxic gases, ano, na nare-release. Alam nyo yung sobra, kahit na maganda yung gases na mga yan sa paligid natin, kapag sobra ay nakakasira ng paligid natin, ano? And ang tawag naman dyan ay greenhouse effect. Ang tawag naman dyan. It is a greenhouse effect. Which leading to global warming. Ayan, yan na ang problema natin. And the question is, how can we be sure that humans are responsible for these increases? So, some greenhouse gases have no natural source. Yun ang problema natin. Itong mga natural gases natin, eh wala silang source. Talagang nandyan na sila. It is existed already. No? And for other gases, two important observations demonstrate human influence. First, the geographic differences in concentrations reveal that sources occur predominantly over land in more heavily populated northern hemisphere. Pag sinabi nating hemisphere, it is half of the globe. And second, analysis of which can distinguish among sources of emissions naman, ano? Yung mga nai-emit na mga carbon monoxide and other form of gases, which demonstrate that the majority of the increase in carbon dioxide came from combustion of fossil fuels, ano, na ito nga yung sinasabi natin na nakakasira ng paligid natin, ano. And methane and nitrous oxide increases derived from agricultural practices and the burning of fossil fuels. Now, the climate scientists use a concept called radiative forcing. Yan. So ano ba itong radiative forcing class? This is the change that is caused in the global energy balance of the earth relative to pre-industrial times. Yan, ano? So, yan nga, yung nagiging cause niyan, kasama na dyan class, yung mga pagputol ng punong kahoy, yan yung sinusunog, no, na nakakaapekto sa ating paligid. So, observe of climate change also, it is refers to the changes in three important quantities. The global temperature, the sea level and snow cover in the northern hemisphere, all show evidence of warming, no? Although the details vary. So, depende daw yung epekto niyan, ano? Meron tayong study dito that the previous IPCC assessment reported a warming trend to 0.6, no? From 0.2 degrees Celsius over the period of 1901 to 2000. And this is because of the strong recent warming, no? The updated trend over 1906 to 2005 is now 0.74 from 0.18 degrees Celsius. So ibig sabihin, tumaas, ano, yung init na nararamdaman natin ngayon. And note that in the 1956 to 2005 trend alone is 0.65 from 0.15 degrees Celsius. It emphasizing that the majority of 20th century warming occurred in the past 50 years. So nararamdaman na daw pala nila noon. Yan, ano, yung climate change. And the climate of course continues to vary around the increased average, and extremes have changed consistently with these averages. Yeah, no? So, in the ocean, we clearly see warming trends. So, that is, ano, under the observed climate changes, no? Now, let's proceed to the attribution of observed changes. And in the, based on the study, although confidence is high, both that human activities have caused a positive radiative forcing and that the climate has actually changed. Meron din namang ano, yung mga progreso na ginagawa nga ng tao upang ang ekonomiya natin ay lumago. Kaya nga lang kasi, siyempre, may mga pros and cons yan na na-experience natin na nararamdaman din na nagkakaroon ng epekto sa lahat, no? And these are the human activities responsible for observed climate changes, or it is possibly the result from some other cause such as the natural forcing or simply spontaneous variability within the climate system, no? So we have the projection of future changes, and this critical question is addressed using simulations from climate models based on projection of future emissions of greenhouse gases and aerosols. When we say aerosol, ano, this refers to the natural, kasi meron tayong kasing artificial o kaya ay natural aerosol, no? So we are referring here to the natural aerosol, just like fog o kaya ay mist, no? Dust o kaya ay forest exudates. Okay, yan yung mga example ano ng aerosol na ito. Yan. Even if emissions were immediately reduced, ano, on based on the study, it is enough to stabilize greenhouse gas concentration at current level. Climate change would continue for centuries. Eh, wala tayong magagawa, talagang ganyan talaga. Nagbabago talaga ang panahon natin, ano? So this inertia in the climate results from a combination of factors, and they include the heat capacity of the world oceans and the millennial timescale needed for the circulation to mix heat and carbon dioxide throughout the deep ocean and thereby come into equilibrium with the new conditions. Yeah. So let's proceed also to the greenhouse gases and their sources. Okay. A particularly important distinction class among them is the varying global warming potentials, o kaya ay yung GWPs. Okay. So some are much more efficient, ano? And that is decidedly not a compliment in this context of greenhouse gases, it retaining heat energy in the atmosphere. Ayan. So, hindi natin masyadong nararamdaman, ano? Because of this greenhouse gases. Not allowing to escape, some are short-lived, while others can easily last decades or longer in the atmosphere. Okay, let's consider the principal GHG, greenhouse gases. This was studied by the National Climate Data Center, ano? Yung NCDC. Yeah. Okay, so number one there is the water vapor. It explains that that changes in the concentration of water vapor result from the climate feedbacks related to the warming of the atmosphere. And on the study, as the temperature of the atmosphere rises, more water is evaporated from ground storage. Yan. Because the air is warmer, the absolute humidity can be higher. Yan, ano? And leading to more water vapor in the atmosphere. Next is the carbon dioxide. Okay. The carbon dioxide, the researchers consider to be the most important greenhouse gases, is an important heat trapping. Ayan, tanda nyo ah, yung carbon dioxide natin is an important heat trapping. In other study, carbon dioxide is used as a refrigerant, no, in fire extinguisher, no, ginagamit nila yan, ano, useful fire extinguisher. Yan, ano? Inflating life rafts and life jackets, blasting coal, foaming rubber and plastics, and promoting the growth of plant in greenhouses. immobilizing animals before slaughter and incarbonated beverage. Next is yung methane. Ano ba naman ang importance ng methane? Methane is a hydrocarbon gas resulting from both natural causes and as a result of human activities such as agriculture and farming. Yan. Is an special potent greenhouse gases and absorber of radiation. Yun ang purpose ng methane. Absorber of radiation, yung methane na yan. So, methane is far less abundant daw, according to the study, than the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and it has a considerably shorter lifespan of 12 years. Yan, ano? And it indicates also that human activities account daw, for over 60% of total methane emissions, primarily from industry, agriculture, and waste management activities. Yan daw yung tulong niya kasi absorber yan, absorber yan ng mga radiation, pati na rin sa mga different industrial sector yung methane na yan. And next is yung nitrous oxide. Okay? Nitrous oxide, this occurs naturally in Earth atmosphere as part of the nitrogen cycle. Yan. And according to the study, while it is the product of a wide variety of natural sources, just like human activities, this human activities includes the agriculture, fossil fuel, combustion, waste water management, and industrial processes, are increasing the atmospheric concentration. Yan, So, in addition, nitrous oxide molecules in the atmosphere have long lifespan, about 120 years before they are removed in a sink or destroyed as a result of chemical reaction. Ayan, so matagal, yan na nasa environment natin or nasa atmosphere. Okay? Next is the fluorinated gases. Yan, ano ba yung fluorinated gases class? Okay? These are emitted in smaller quantities than the other greenhouse gases, but they lack in volume. They can make up in potency in long lifespan in the atmosphere. So, according to the study class, once emitted in the atmosphere, they disperse widely around the globe. Ayan. So, kumakalat siya, no? They are removed from the atmosphere only by sunlight in the highest level of the atmosphere. Ayan. So, being the most potent of the greenhouse gases and having the longest lifespan, ang fluorinated gases. Ayan. So, minsan, ginagamit din ito as emitter, emitter ng aluminum and semiconductor manufacturing process. Ayan. So, take note for that, no? Now, let's proceed to the global warming. No, when we see global warming, this is the long-term warming of the planet's overall temperature. And based on the study, this warming trend has been going on for a long time. It faced a significant increase in the last 100 years due to the burning of fossil fuels. As the human population has increased, so as the volume of fossil fuels burn, fossil fuels include coal, oil, and natural gas, and burning them causes what is known as the greenhouse effect. Yan. So, kung ito daw ay nasusunog, kasi alam naman natin kapag sobra, mayroon talagang effect yan. So, itong mga greenhouse gases na na-discuss natin kanina ay nasisira ito, at yun nga ang tawag yan ay greenhouse effect. Yan. Okay, so kapag nangyari, ang tawag na natin dyan ay magkakaroon ng global warming. Okay, so ano ba ang pinagkaiba ng climate change sa global warming? Pag sinabi natin climate change, this refers to the changes in weather patterns in growing stations around the world. No? So it also refers to sea level rise caused by the expansion of warmer seas and melting ice sheets and glaciers. While global warming naman class is the causes of climate change, which poses a serious threat to a life on Earth. Yan, ha? So nagkakaroon ng panganib sa Earth, sa buong mundo. So yan yung global warming. Yan, yan yung pinagkaiba niya. Okay? So, how about the climate change scenarios or the socio-economic scenario, class, ano? These are projections of future greenhouse gas emissions used by analysts to assess future vulnerability to climate change. So, meron tayong mga scientists, ano, na talagang nag-aaral ng pagbabago ng panahon natin. And ito yung ini-study nila, ina-analyze nila, ano? And producing scenario, yung scenario natin. So, they predict the future, kung ano yung magiging future natin. Just like producing scenarios requires estimate of future population level. Yan. And to include economic activity, the structure of governance, social values, and patterns of technological change. Yan. So, to include class, the economic and energy modeling. Yan na. Which can be used to analyze the quantify the effect of such effect. Yan, ano? So, scientists can develop separate international, regional, and national climate change scenario. Okay, these scenarios are designed to help stakeholders understand what kind of decision will have meaningful effect on climate change, mitigation, or adaptation. As I have said, talagang year ago, and then future, climate change is inevitable. So, wala tayong magagawa. Talagang nagbabago ang panahon natin. So, what we are going to do is mitigate the effect of climate change o kaya ay we need to adapt it. Yan. So, most countries developing adaptation plans. Ano? So, meron silang ganyan, adaptation plans or nationally determined contributions will commission scenario studies in order to better understand the decision available to them. Okay, so meron tayong rising greenhouse gases and this was associated with the scenarios having a growing post-industrial economy. Yan, with globalization. So, ibig sabihin yan, class, that talagang hindi tatagal talagang pro-progreso ang isang bayan, ang isang lugar. Yan nga, it has a globalization na post-industrial economy, no, which mostly with low government intervention and generally high level of competition. While falling naman of greenhouse gases and this showed economic activity limited at an ecologically sustainable level. So the scenarios with falling emissions had a high level of government intervention in the economy. The majority of scenarios showed increased social equity and income quality equality within the within and among nations.